So I'm back here in front of the art department hallway, and right next to the art department hallway there is this black box theater and a professional learning center where teachers often use to have meetings. I can show you guys a closer look. I used to have my grade 9 design audio class right here, and there's a lot of comfy chairs as you saw, which is really nice. This is the Black Box Theater. The Black Box Theater is often used for very small events or photo shoots. We can turn on the... You can see... This is the Black Box Theater! This Black Box Theater is used for small events that require, for example, only a single grade level. And it is also used for some small musical shows as well. These are all the seats around. And because it is the Black Box Theater, it actually looks like a box. And that is that's the booth for the Black Box Theater right there. And that is the podium where people can talk. I don't think the mic will be on right now because there's nobody in the booth and nothing's turned on. But I just wanted to show you guys how this looks like. Now I've shown you guys the Black Box Theater and the Professional Learning Center. We're gonna head this way. And I'm gonna show you inside the theater from the balcony view. I've got this theater card from our teacher, Miss Melly. Because I'm part of theater tech, I can do this. Ta-da! This is school theater. This is the balcony seats. And these are the main seats down there. And as you can see, there's a piano there. I don't know why, but there's a piano there. There's a podium right there. And you can see lights hanging from here. And yeah, this is how our main theater looks like. You can see it's very large and nice and neat. So we held a lot of large events. So whereas we hold our small events in the Black Box Theater, if we have events that are involving more than a grade, normally it will be inside the main theater. But because of COVID and we have to space out, we normally have a single grade in here these days, but normally we would have more. So I'm back outside the balcony. And we're gonna head this way, and I'm gonna show you guys some PE classrooms. Not the gym, but PE classrooms. This is the PE board where teachers write where they have class so that students can find the appropriate location. If you head this way, this is the PE hallway. As you can see, there's a PE teacher's office right here. It's always all the blinds are always down. This is one of the men's locker room. And this is the gymnastics room. It's kind of messy right now, but this is how it looks like with this comfy floor. This is how the gymnastics room looks like. And if you head this way, they're having class, but there's a PE classroom right here. This is varsity boys locker room. And at the very end of the hallway, there is another room. This is varsity girls locker room. This is just the women's locker room. And there's another multi-purpose room. PE classroom. I don't know if I'm allowed to go in, so I'm just gonna keep it out. There's another PE classroom right here. This is the third floor of above the athletics hallway that I showed you. This is the dance room. It's currently not open, but it is a room, a dance room, because the floor is made with marley. And you can see cycles right there. Right there. We would come in the dance room and cycle or do any other athletic stuff if it is raining or the weather is bad in our PE days. This is the fitness room. Some people are working out right here. I believe they have some kind of athletics in here. As you can see, there are diverse fitness things that you can do in this room. I came down from the PE hallway, and now here are the gyms on my left. That was the aux gym. This is just the gym, large one. And this is the PE storage, where all the PE equipments are here. Diverse PE equipments. Yes. This is the girls' locker room. I'm not gonna show inside because of privacy. I don't know who's gonna be in there, so. But inside the locker room, there are these same lockers inside, and also a bathroom with three stalls, I think. And there's a large shower room where people can shower, take a shower. But showering is not recommended right now because of COVID, but there still is, and you can still use one if you're a child student. This is the upper school athletic storage, but it looks practically the same as the village school one. This is the deck. They're currently busy right now because there's outdoor education going on for other grades, but this is essentially how it looks like. And there are more PE equipments right here. And this is where there are boats right there for OE. And this is just the area where people get ready for outdoor ed. I'll show you around inside the gym. This is a large gym of our school. And right now, village schoolers are having class inside. These will always be pulled out whenever we have events so that people can sit here and during games as well. And this is where varsity games and all the important stuff happen. Outside the gyms, there are these walls with all the athletic awards that our students received. So there's upper school walls, and this is the middle school awards building. And mission statement of the CIMS Athletic Council, which is once I was affiliated in the Athletic Council in middle school. So that's quite meaningful because I contributed to the mission statement. And this is the aux gym. That climbing wall right there, it's really cool. And like, if there's this first aid, and that's all we have in the gyms. They're currently having a PE class right here. Now, at the end of the gym hallway, we have this aquatic center, essentially the swimming pool. So yes, here are school records. I once had one when I was in village school, fifth grade. I'll just show you guys quickly inside. You've probably seen, if you were following up with my YouTube, you probably have seen the swimming pool because I had a swimming class here before. And except for the 11th and 12th graders, all grades have a PE class. And 1 month is always, always, always dedicated to swimming lessons. Also, there are after-school swimming CICPs and swimming athletic groups that swim inside this pool, which is really nice. And we host swim meets, large swim meets as well.